Neo, meaning new, and lithic. I T H I C, meaning stone. All right, let's get back to this site. Turkdean Barrow near Hazleton. Contains a central passage and three chambers or cysts. Don't confuse that with robbing, in which case we mean the removal of the contents of the barrel. This site also demonstrates one of the great dangers of archaeology, not to life and limb, although that does sometimes take place. No, I'm talking about folklore. In this case, local tradition held that there was a golden coffin buried at the site. And this accounts for the holes dug all over the barrow and the generally poor condition of the find. However, chamber three was undisturbed, and the undisturbed chamber and the grave goods that were found in another, in the area, give us a... reason to date this find as we have. Any questions, then? No, okay, that's it for the day, then. Don't forget, Michelson, chapters 4 and 5 for next time. And I will be in my office on Thursday, but not Wednesday.
I had it, Marcus. I had it in my hand.
What happened?
Yes.
Huh. Bad luck?
You want to hear about it?
Not at all. I'm sure everything you do for the museum conforms to the International Treaty for the Protection of Antiquities.
It's beautiful, Marcus. I can get it. I got it all figured out. There's no one place you can sell it, Marrakesh. I need $2,000.
Listen to me, young boy. I've brought some people to see you.
Look, I got these pieces. They're good pieces, Marcus.
Look, Indiana. Yes, the museum will buy them as usual. No questions asked. Yes, they are nice.
They're worth at least the price of a ticket to Marrakesh.
But the people I brought are important and they're waiting.
What people?
The Army Intelligence. I knew you were coming before I did. See to know everything. You couldn't tell me what they want.
Well, what do I want to see them for? What am I, in trouble?
Serials are a major staple of early American cinema. Hundreds of men, women, and children would flock to local movie houses every week to catch the latest adventures of Zorro, Batman, Flash Gordon, Tarzan, and many others. The influences of these episodic films inspired genres such as science fiction and action adventure. It also provides the influence for this week's film in a franchise that has been one of the best for over 40 years. Released in 1981, directed by Steven Spielberg, and based on a story by Star Wars director George Lucas, Raiders of the Lost Ark starts the Indiana Jones franchise, and many argue Harrison Ford's greatest role, and takes place in 1936 as Jones, an archaeologist, takes on the mission to battle Nazis vying to gain control of the all-powerful Lost Ark of the Covenant. Aiding Jones is former love interest Marion Ravenwood, played by Karen Allen. Our opening clip was an introduction to Jones, an archaeology professor by day that moonlights as an adventurous archaeologist, finding treasures for a museum. Our next two clips provide more introduction to these characters, Jones and Ravenwood. First, in a direct continuation from our introductory clip, Indy is tasked by Army Intelligence to go on a mission to find the famed Lost Ark before the Nazis do. Then, we will hear the terse reunion between Marion and Indy, former lovers brought together by world-saving circumstances.
And Dr. Jones, we've heard a great deal about you.
Have you?
Professor of archaeology, expert on the occult, and how does one say it? Obtainer of rare antiquities.
One way of saying it. Why don't you sit down? You'll be more comfortable.
Thank you. Thank you. Yes, you're a man of many talents. You studied under Professor Ravenwood at the University of Chicago.
Yes, I did.
You have no idea of his present whereabouts?
Just rumors, really. Somewhere in Asia, I think. I haven't really spoken to him for 10 years. We were friends, but, had a bit of a falling out, I'm afraid.
Dr. Jones, now, you must understand that this is all strictly confidential, eh?
I understand.
yesterday afternoon, our European sections intercepted a German communique that was sent from Cairo to Berlin.
Now, you see, over the last two years, the Nazis have had teams of archaeologists running around the world looking for all kinds of religious artifacts. Hitler's a nut on the subject. He's crazy. He's obsessed with the occult. And right now, apparently, there's some kind of German archaeological dig going on in the desert outside of Cairo.
Now, we've got some information here, but we can't make anything out of it, and maybe you can. Tanis development proceeding. Acquire headpiece, staff of Ra, Abner Ravenwood, U.S.
Nazis have discovered Tanis.
Just what does that mean to you, Tanis?
Well,
the city of Tanis is one of the possible resting places of the Lost Ark.
The Lost Ark?
Yeah, the Ark of the Covenant, the chest the Hebrews used to carry around the Ten Commandments.
What do you mean, Ten Commandments? You're talking about the Ten Commandments?
Yes, the actual Ten Commandments, the original stone tablets that Moses brought down out of Mount Horeb and smashed, if you believe in that sort of thing.
Did you guys ever go to Sunday school?
Well, look.
The Hebrews took the broken pieces and put them in the Ark. When they settled in Canaan, they put the Ark in a place called the Temple of Solomon.
In Jerusalem.
Where it stayed for many years. Until all of a sudden, whoosh, is gone.
Where?
Well, nobody knows where or when.
However, an Egyptian pharaoh...
Shishak.
Yes, invaded the city of Jerusalem around about 980 BC, and he may have taken the Ark back to the city of Tanis and hidden it in a secret chamber called the Well of Souls.
Secret chamber.
However, about a year after the pharaoh had returned to Egypt, the city of Tanis was consumed by the desert in a sandstorm which lasted a whole year. Wiped clean by the wrath of God.
Obviously, we've come to the right man. Now, you seem to know all about this, Tanis.
No, not really. Ravenwood is the real expert. Abner did the first serious work on Tanis. He collected some of its relics. It was his obsession, really. But he never found the city.
Frankly, we're somewhat suspicious of Mr. Ravenwood, American being mentioned so prominently in a secret Nazi cable.
Oh, rubbish. Ravenwood's no Nazi.
Well, what did the Nazis want him for, then?
Well, obviously, the Nazis are looking for the headpiece to the staff of Ra, and they think Abner's got it.
What exactly is a headpiece to the staff of Ra?
Well, the staff is just a stick. I don't know, about this big. Nobody really knows for sure how high. And it's capped with an elaborate headpiece in the shape of the sun with a crystal in the center. And what you did was you take the staff to a special room in Tanis, a map room with a miniature of the city all laid out on the floor. And if you put the staff in a certain place at a certain time of day, the sun shone through here and made a beam that came down on the floor here and gave you the exact location of the Well of the Souls.
Where the Ark of the Covenant was kept, right?
Which is exactly what the Nazis are looking for.
Now, what does this Ark look like?
There's a picture of it right here. That's it.
Good God.
Yes, that's just what the Hebrews thought.
Now, what's that supposed to be coming out of there?
Lightning. Fire. Power of God or something.
I'm beginning to understand Hitler's interest in this.
Oh, yes. The Bible speaks of the Ark leveling mountains and laying waste to entire regions. An army which carries the Ark before it is invincible.
And now, Marion and Indy.
Hello, Marion.
Oh, Indiana Jones. Always knew someday you'd come walking back through my door. I never doubted that. Something made it inevitable. So what are you doing here in Nepal?
I need one of the pieces your father collected.
I learned to hate you in the last 10 years.
I never meant to hurt you.
I was a child. I was in love. It was wrong and you knew it.
You knew what you were doing.
Now I do. This is my place. Get out. Mohan, Temigaru, Bulianu.
I did what I did. You don't have to be happy about it, but maybe we can help each other out now. I need one of the pieces your father collected. Bronze piece about this size with a hole in it off center with a crystal. You know the one I mean?
Yeah, I know it.
Where's Abner? Where's Abner?
Abner's dead.
Marion, I'm sorry.
Do you know what you did to me in my life?
I can only say I'm sorry so many times.
Well, say it again anyway.
Sorry.
Yeah, everybody's sorry. Abner was sorry for dragging me all over this earth looking for his little bits of junk. I'm sorry to still be stuck in this dive. Everybody's sorry for something.
It's a worthless bronze medallion, Marion. You're gonna give it to me?
Maybe. I don't know where it is.
Well, maybe you could find it. $3,000.
Well, that will get me back. But not in style.
I can get you another two when we get to the States. It's important, Marion. Trust me. You know the piece I mean? You know where it is?
Come back tomorrow.
Why?
Because I said so, that's why. See you tomorrow, Indiana Jones.
A great action-adventure film is as only as good as its hero. And conversely, the hero is only as good as the villain. Besides the aforementioned Nazis, this film has the nefarious Dr. Rene Belloc, played by Paul Williams. Belloc is not the typical villain that moviegoers encounter during this era. He was not loud, angry, and hot-tempered. He is cold, callous, and deliberate. So much so, it might even be considered charming. Our next two clips are examples of this. First, Indy encounters his rival while he is intoxicated after believing Marion has died. Then, Belloc confronts Marion after capturing her.
Dr. Jones, der Herr in der Bar möchte mit Ihnen sprechen. Kommen Sie bitte mit uns.
You looking for me? Belloc.
Good afternoon, Dr. Jones.
I ought to kill you right now.
Not a very private place for a murder.
Well, these Arabs don't care if we kill each other. They're not going to interfere in our business.
It was not I who brought the girl into this business. Please sit down before you fall down. We can at least behave like civilized people.
See, your taste in friends remains consistent. How odd that it should end this way for us after so many stimulating encounters. I almost regret it. Where shall I find a new adversary so close to my own level?
Try the local sewer.
You and I are very much alike. Archaeology is our religion. Yet we have both fallen from the pure faith. Our methods have not differed as much as you pretend. I am a shadowy reflection of you. It'll take only a nudge to make you like me, to push you out of the light.
Now you're getting nasty.
You know it's true. How nice. Look at this. It's worthless. $10 from a vendor in the street. But I take it and bury it in the sand for 1,000 years, it becomes priceless. Like the Ark. Men will kill for it. Men like you and me.
What about your boss, Der Fuhrer? I thought he was waiting to take possession.
All in good time. When I'm finished with it. Jones, do you realize what the Ark is? It's a transmitter. It's a radio for speaking to God. And it's within my reach.
You want to talk to God? Let's go see him together. I've got nothing better to do.
Next time, Indiana Jones, it'll take more than children to save you.
I thought I would find you there. Better than the United States Marines, eh?
Marion's dead.
Yes, I know. I'm sorry. Life goes on, Indy. There is the proof. I have much to tell you. First, we will take them home, and then I will take it to the old man.
Next, Belloc and Marion.
If you're trying to escape on foot, the desert is 3 weeks in every direction. So please eat something. I must apologize for their treatment of you.
Yeah, who thought you wanted? No food, no water. What kind of people are these friends of yours?
This particular time and place, and for my work, they are necessary evils. They're not my friends. However, with the right connections, even in this part of the world, we are not entirely uncivilized.
It's beautiful.
I would very much like to see you in it.
A better one. All right.
What do you got to drink around here?
We do not have much time. Soon they will come to arm you, and I will not be able to stop them. Unless you are able to give me something to placate them. Some piece of information, which I can use to protect you from them.
I've already told you everything I know. I have no loyalty to Jones. He's brought me nothing but trouble.
Marion, you are beautiful.
I don't think you need a chaperone.
So many of the common tropes of action-adventure films are excellently applied in this film. With that being said, of course, there has to be a love story. And this film has one. That is the one between, of course, Marion and Dr. Jones. As a matter of fact, it's a story that stretches across the entire franchise. In our final clip, Marion proceeds to help Indy clean up following a battle, and their relationship begins to grow again. This scene also features one of the most well-known lines in the entire franchise.
Where'd you get that?
From him.
Who, him?
Katanga. I've got a feeling I'm not the first woman to travel with these pirates.
It's lovely.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
What'd you say?
Wait. I don't need any help.
You do. Not the man I knew 10 years ago.
It's not the years. It's the mileage. Please, I don't need a nurse. I just want to sleep.
He's such a baby.
Marion, leave
me. Why is this here?
Go away. Yes.
Where doesn't it hurt?
Here. Here. This is too bad.
Jones, we never seem to get a break, do we?
This film was released during a brief dry spell for Hollywood. Business had been down for the past year. It was felt by many that this film would be buried, going up against such films as Superman 2, For Your Eyes Only, and The Great Muppet Caper. That, coupled with very low awareness regarding the film, had Paramount prepared for the absolute worst. Despite everything going against it, the film became the highest-grossing film of 1981. It generated over $330 million worldwide. The film was nominated for 9 Academy Awards, including Best Picture and Best Director. It won 5. For Best Art Direction, Best Film Editing, Best Sound Editing, and Best Visual Effects. The film has been a juggernaut in marketing as well, spawning video games, TV spin-offs, action figures, novels, trading cards, and so forth. It has been an influence on characters such as Lara Croft from Tomb Raider. Finally, this film spanned 4 sequels that have been released over the last 42 years. The final film premiered on June 29th, 2023. To know what a great franchise this series is, one must see where it began, and you will see it is deserving of its place in the upper tier of all-time greats. I hope you will join me in 2 weeks when we will go on a vacation with the lovable, comedic Griswold family. Our film will be National Lampoon's Vacation. For WMNH and Matt Connerton Unleashed, this has been a classic film review with Eric Pilcher.